Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn about set interval and set timeout functions in JavaScript. But currently we are actually working on a jQuery. So these are actually functions of JavaScript, but we are going to use those functions in jQuery. Most of the time, the students fail to understand the basic function of the set interval and set timeout. The reason is that both functions have similarity in syntax. But the applications of set interval are different than set timeout. Though both are actually called after some delay or some interval of the time. But what happens once we use a set interval, then in the set interval function, when the function is called after 2 or 3 or 4 seconds, that is actually the time delay, then function is actually keeps on calling. And so in that scenario, means a function is repeatedly called. While if we talk about the set timeout, then in set timeout, what happens? The function is called after certain time delay only for once. So that is the basic difference between a set interval and a set timeout. In today's task, we are going to learn about set interval and set timeout. And in first, we are actually going to cover the set interval, and we see how set interval works, and then we switch to set timeout, and we shall actually in the later part of this lecture, we shall actually stop the set interval function forcefully, and so that a user can actually perform the certain events. Like the user want to actually start the event, or the user doesn't want to start the event. So that actually task we are going to perform today. So we are going to start the lecture. So before starting the lecture, I would request you to subscribe the channel and click the bell icon so that you can get the notifications about the upcoming lectures. And we start the lecture now. So we create a new file in HTML, and we name this set interval and set timeout. All right. Our first task is actually to include the jQuery official library. So script type is equals to text slash JavaScript, and source is equals to our JS folder. All right. Now script type is equals to text slash JavaScript. Right, now we create a jQuery document ready function. Once this ready function is called, let us test window.alert. Working, we type localhost, and our folder is actually jQuery, then set interval. It is not working. What is the issue? We have to see. Okay, here is the issue. Right. Okay, it is working fine. Now let us come into this and we create a div and we assign a div id is equals to box, and we write something. This is a box div. Right. Okay, what we do here, we apply some basic styles to this div. So we write a style and a hash box, which is our selector. Okay, then we specify width of the div. Suppose the width of the div is 200 px and height of the div 200 px, and we specify the border. Let's say it's a solid and 5px and it's a dark orange. All right, so what we do next, we actually the main work that is actually on a set interval. So we actually first create a set interval function. For this we write a set interval, and the first argument it actually takes is a function. Then you have to specify the time delay. So we call this function after every 2 seconds. So we specify 2000 milliseconds is equals to 2 seconds. Okay, now what we do here, we create one variable. Let's suppose we create a variable colors. So we specify one array. Let's suppose we are having different colors, green and yellow. But a green and aqua and blue or dark blue. All right, so this is our array. Okay, now our next task is actually to assign styles to the div. So for this, what we do, we say jQuery hash box dot css and background of the div should be colors. And from colors, we have array. So what we do here, we create one variable named is equals to count, and we specify here count. Okay, and this count should actually increment at every function call, so it will be incremented. But since we have only 3 colors, so array size is 3. It starts from 0, 1 and 2. So we don't want that count should actually increase greater than 2. So if we say that we specify if count equals to 3, what should happen? The count should be again reset it to 0. All right, so let us execute this. Hope this works. Okay, after 2 seconds the color of the div is getting changed. It is assigned green, then the next color will be assigned. Okay, what is happening? Count plus 1, not, but count plus equals to 1. We did a mistake. Now we actually check. Okay, so the color of the div is getting changed. So it is actually repeatedly, it is changed, it doesn't stop. So this is what I just wanted to tell you. The purpose of the set interval function is that when you are going to do the task that requires repeatedly calling a function, then of course you can actually do the set interval. But if you want that the function should be called only once after a certain delay or certain time interval, then you will use the set timeout. Okay, so what we want to do here, we actually want to stop this background color of the box. So after a certain interval of time or the user clicks stop, then it should stop. Okay, so what we do here, we actually create a one button input type is equals to button and name is equals to btn and value is equals to stop and id is equals to stop. All right, so what we do here, first of all, the task is that this set interval should be stored in one variable. Let's say that variable my animation is equals to this. Now what we do here, we say that once the button is clicked, hash stop dot click, then function should be called. Okay, so what it should do, in JavaScript there is a one function named as a clear interval, and once it is actually this button is clicked, then we pass this my animation to this. So we check this whether this works or not. So currently it is actually changing the colors. So once we click the stop, hope it stops. All right, so means if this has stopped, so forcefully we can actually stop this set interval, and again if I refresh, then this will work, and I can stop this. So this is working fine. All right, now our next task is to actually learn about the set timeout. So this is the same animation what I do here. I just change this set interval to set timeout, and I comment this code refresh this. Okay, so you can see that the function has been called only for once. Again, if I refresh, the function is called only for once. So this is the basic difference between the set interval and the set timeout. So hopefully you have understood this lecture, and it actually differentiates between set interval and set timeout. So this is quite easy what you will do. First you will include the jQuery library, and then you will start the document ready function, and here I have just created one box and the button The purpose of the box here is actually to change the colors and apply some animation of my own. So what I did, I just made a one array, and also I made a one function set for the first time. I made a one function called a set interval. That was actually to actually apply the different colors at a certain interval of time. It was the first task, and in this task what I did, I actually used only set timeout, which is not actually changing the different colors, because the function is being called only for once. So that is the basic difference. So this is, this code is quite neat and clean and very easy to understand. So hope you have enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.